not steady, does it? Nice and steady. Okay, let's just see if I can take it back over here. The ground looks a bit more stable. And I'm just going to walk it down nice and gradually. I like Cornwall, but I don't like roads like this, thank you very much, adventure bike rider. My feet are sliding everywhere, I've got hardly any grip. So, I think the secret here is don't rush, because we're not in a rush. Just walk it down. Looks to be better just down there. So if I can just get around this corner, I've sorted it. Oh, maybe. Rush. So then it's saying up the hill. Up the hill. So keep a bit of gas on, not too much. Let's have a look at that. That looks doable. Go over with this guy. Do 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 do. Always better to check. So again, I'll just take it nice and steady up here. What I will do, first of all, is I want that on minimum. Holy shit, that was horrible. God, I didn't enjoy that. Right, let's put the suspension back into auto. Okay, so I'm going to try and avoid little subtle hints at road. That only just passed as a road. Put the bike back into road mode. Alright, take a left here. Thank you. You forget sometimes that it's not just cars that come down these roads. Right, on here for 3.5 miles. Straight over this junction by the looks of it. And then down here. Are we clear? We are indeed. degrees, I'm getting quite warm. It'd be nice to get a bit of air flowing through the jacket. So I'm about halfway through the trail at the moment, so I'm happy with that, because as I said before, certainly not in a rush. I want to enjoy this. It's highly unlikely I'll get back down this neck of the woods, this specific part of the country of Cornwall, this year, so it would be nice to just to enjoy it. Thank you. That's a nice property. This is quite good compared with that other bit. Okay. Bit smoky here. That's a nice looking church. Ooh, I'm back into civilization. Thank goodness for that. So I take a right here. You wouldn't think there was a storm or two storms last week. Nature does repair itself very quickly. Things get blown away. Farmers will move stuff. So we're heading next onto the B3042. Just up the road here. I don't know, it's sort of saying straight on, isn't it? Fair enough. Looks doable. Let's get over this bit first. There we go. It's really strong here, the smell of the country. It smells like they've been muck spreading. Unless it's possible actually, I can still smell the coast. Maybe that's my imagination. It smells sort of salty, seaweedy. This looks a bit dodgy again. Not too bad. Still be difficult on here to turn around though if you had to. Is that a fox? I believe it is a fox. It is a fox. I've just seen a little wild fox. ...150 yards, take a right. Okay, I'm just gonna slow down again here. I can see a traffic cone, that's never a good sign. I'm just gonna walk the bike down here, nice and steady. Quite sure what the significance of that cone is. So it's saying take a right here. So I'm going to bear right. This side looks significantly better than the left side. It looks all right once you get through here. least here, this left turning I'm coming up, it's called a proper name, Church Street. Not like some of the tracks where you literally it just says road and you just think it's not a road, is it? So I want to go, oh, the road just goes up here anyway, so that's fine. And carry on here. All the daffodils are out there. They don't normally come out, do they, till spring? A bit early. Not a gardener though, so I might not know that. I always thought they came out in spring. There's a lot of mud on the road here. Just be mindful of that on the corners. In particular on the corners. So it's 1 o'clock now, and it's saying I'll arrive at Ivy Bridge at 2:44, so 1¾ hours. So I am heading in the right direction. So we've got a bit of a dogleg here, which I think is this one. Yep. And then straight up here. Down St. Mary. 20's plenty. They're nice properties. So around to the left, and then down to the right, down here. So we've got another one of these wonderful things here where it says road. What does it look like? Yeah, it looks alright. Quite pristine compared with some of them. So we're heading now towards the A3072, half a mile ahead. And take a right here. Heading towards Oakhampton. I know where that is. Another property with a thatched roof. Find another one down there. You still see them scattered around in some of the older villages. Right, I'll just turn the camera off. I'm just going to do a couple of pictures here and have a bit of a breather, and I'll come back to you shortly. Right, off we go again. We're all recording. Ignition on. It's clear, and off we go. So that was the village of Bow, B-O-W. So we're taking a left here toward Launceston, or Launceston, I think it's Launceston. The A30. More lovely farmyard smells. So we're just coming up to the A30 now. Looks like we go over it and then ride parallel to it. So that'll be the A30 there below me. So right here onto the A382 towards Moreton Hampstead, or Hampstead. Another horse up ahead. Plenty of them, aren't they? So our first exit off here onto the A382. 6 miles. So this is Dartmoor National Park we're just entering. Alright, straight on here. Second exit towards Bovey Tracy. Princetown. There we go. ¾ miles to Princetown. So 2:20 now, an hour is telling me to get to Ivy Bridge. So I knew I was going to get home late, but I'm not that bothered about that. I wanted to maximise my time down here, and I think I've done that. Stopped where I wanted to do some photography and videoing and so forth. So that's the purpose of this trip. So where we are now, Dartmoor, 40 mile an hour zone. Animals on the road, take care. So let's see if we can see any ponies or anything of that nature, or sheep. So this is one of the highlights for me, coming over Dartmoor. Just experiencing the wildness and the natural environment up here. It looks like there's some, I'm not sure what they are, whether they are ponies or stones. There's plenty of sheep. No ponies yet. This is pretty magnificent, isn't it? See if I can find a viewpoint or something like that. Somewhere high up. I can get the bike parked up safely, not causing the obstruction, and take a picture looking out over those moors there. They'll be quite tame here, these sheep. Don't think they'll scurry away too much. They're totally oblivious, I think, like a lot of sheep, to traffic. Might get the odd one that's a bit skittish. Seem more intent on just chewing up grass, don't they? I wonder if they're doing the challenge. It'd be funny if they were. How'd you do? Straight on here. What have we got here? National Park. East Dart Hotel. That's a nice little bridge. I might go and have a little wonder at that. So this is the National Park Visitors Centre at Postbridge. See if I can park up somewhere. It's a bit steep, is this, to park the bike? Should be alright over there though. Or possibly even just go stick it back down the bottom here. This'll do. Okay, that says no parking in front of that property, private property. Should be right here. Alright, let's just go and have a look at this little lovely bridge. Yeah, so that's a quaint little bridge. I mean, how do they make things like that? How do they get those stone slabs into position? Bizarre. Let's see if it'll take my weight. But yeah, what a view. Very good. And off we go. Very isolated house, isn't it? Old farmhouse in pink, the cherry brook, hence the colour. Princetown and Plymouth, did that say? I believe it did. And Princetown. Right, kick that stand down and see if I can get a picture here. See if I have any phone signal and ring the missus. Right, a couple of quick pictures taken there, just on the outskirts of Princetown. And now I'm just going to go into the village, see if I can find somewhere to eat because I'm getting hungry, get a drink, and then see where I need to go from here. I don't think I've got far at all before I get to Ivy Bridge. And then I'll be heading home. Uh, Get it back onto me. I always like to have the bike set up on the tyre pressures. Right then, Princetown. So I read somewhere that there's an old police station here that's converted into a cafe or something. See if I can find it. Just have a quick look down here. There we go. Just turn around up here. Is the best place to park. I could probably get it in there. The only thing is, I'll see if I can park it on the main road. Okay, so I'll go get a bite to eat and I'll catch up with you guys later.